According to a Magnify Money survey by LendingTree, 51% of Americans will make a money resolution for 2021. That's up 47% from this year. Joining us to discuss is Ryan Payne, president of Payne Capital Management. Ryan, great to have you with us on the show today. Now, according to the same survey, 62% who set 2020 financial resolutions changed it because of the coronavirus crisis. How do you think people will evolve their financial resolutions for 2021 as a result of the pandemic?
Well, I think we learned a lot from this past year, and I think that the bottom line is it's a good reminder that as bad as things get, eventually things do get better. And I think we're hopefully on the upward trajectory here with that vaccine coming. And I think that, you know, all the uncertainty we had this year really proved to be an opportunity. So if you've been sitting in cash, you've been trying to figure out should you up your savings game and things like that, I think this year is a good reminder of the world doesn't end very often, and you should get on your plan right away.
That's a very good point. Ryan, we know that reducing debt, increasing credit scores, and boosting savings ranked high on consumers' financial resolutions for 2021. When does it make sense to pay down debt before saving and vice versa, especially amid all this uncertainty?
Yeah, well, I think first off, there's good debt and there's bad debt, right? If you have a credit card and you're borrowing at like 15%, you know, pay that off immediately. Don't waste time on that. But on the other hand, right now, you have interest rates at the lowest level ever, Nora. So for a lot of my clients, you know, we've done refinancing of their mortgage this year, which is just a huge savings. And you can refinance for under 3%, which is just unheard of. So I think you really got to look at your borrowing rate first off. And if it's bad debt, again, get rid of it. But if it's good debt and you're borrowing cheaply, then I wouldn't rush to pay that off. Instead, you can go and invest your money right now. And you just look at, like, you know, a diversified portfolio could pay 3-4%, that could be higher than what your borrowing rate actually is. So the kind of things you want to look at when you're deciding what's a real liability that should be paid off and what money should be invested.
And it's not just this year or next year. The continued economic impact of the pandemic will likely serve as a barrier for consumers' financial goals, maybe for years to come. With all of that uncertainty in mind, how should you plan for more realistic financial resolutions?
Well, like the old saying goes, you know, the journey of 1,000 miles starts with the first step. And my last name is Payne, so I say no pain, no gain. What I mean by that is, you know, you just got to get started. And I know it's the hardest. It's like, you know, when you go to the gym for the first time, it sucks. There's no getting around it. That first time you go, your muscles are sore. You're like, why am I doing this again? And I think it's the same thing with your finances, just getting that start. And just starting to say, okay, I'm going to put away $100 or $500 a month, whatever it happens to be for you. It may feel like a very small thing, but momentum is really what kind of gets the ball rolling. And it's the same thing. Like after you've been going to the gym for a couple months, you start to feel good. It gets easier. It's the same thing with your financial health. You just got to get started, Nora.
And thanks to Ryan Payne, president of Payne Capital Management.